Hi there, you are watching IndianExpress.com videos. On Eid ul-Fitr, clashes were reported between locals and security personnel in at least three places in Jammu and Kashmir. Police used tear gas to disperse crowds after locals resorted to stone pelting in Anantnag. Clashes were also reported in Sopore and Srinagar. Meanwhile, crowds gathered in huge numbers to offer prayers at Eidgahs and mosques. The biggest gathering was witnessed at Hazrat Bal Shrine, where more than 50,000 faithful offered prayers. They said the second largest gathering was held at the Eidgah in the Old City with more than 40,000 people. According to our reports, the authorities have also placed top separatist leaders included Saeed Ali Gilani and Mirwais Umar Farooq under house arrest, fearing that their presence at large Eid gatherings could spark violence. Last week, a Jammu and Kashmir policeman was lynched outside Srinagar's Jamia Masjid while he was on duty. Deputy Superintendent Muhammad Ayub Pandit was allegedly taking pictures of those visiting the mosque before he was attacked by an irate mob. For more news and updates, log on to IndianExpress.com. Heaping praise on India's military prowess, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has said that the country can defend itself and has convinced the world that the menace of terrorism needs to be eliminated. Speaking about India's surgical strikes on terror launch pads across the LOC last year after the Uri attack, the Prime Minister said that these strikes were proof that the nation can stand up in its own defense when needed. 5 hours before Prime Minister Narendra Modi landed at the Andrews Air Force Base, US President Donald Trump had set the topics for the visit by tweeting, "Look forward to welcoming India's PM Modi to White House on Monday. Important strategic issues to discuss with a true friend." At least 9 people were dead and 28 missing after a boat carrying tourists sank in a reservoir in northwestern Colombia. Authorities have not disclosed yet what caused the 4-deck carrier to go down in the El Peñol reservoir. Kapil Sharma is happy and so is his teammate Kiku Sharma, and the reason for this is that their friend and co-actor Chandan Prabhakar, also known as Chandu Chaiwala, has finally returned on the Kapil Sharma show. Kiku Sharda treated the show's fans with an image of Kapil and Chandan together from the show's sets. India walked to a 105-run win over West Indies in the second ODI, giving them a 1-0 lead in the series after the first match was washed out. It was India's highest margin of victory against West Indies in the latter's own stomping ground.